Hello, Standard 8. We have started with the chapter, the fundamental salient features of our constitution. And in the salient features of our constitution, we are doing fundamental rights. Okay, now we completed some of the fundamental rights. Today we will be doing right to freedom of religion. Right to freedom of religion. And now, right to freedom of religion is mentioned under Article 25 to 28. So, Article 25 to 28 explains the right to freedom of religion. Every individual has got this freedom. Okay, they have a freedom to profess, practice, and propagate their religion. This is right to freedom of religion, where we are free to profess, practice, and propagate our religion. So it means that all person entitled to freedom of conscience and the right to freely profess, practice and propagate their religion. It's very simple. We are free to profess, practice and propagate our religion. Second thing which you have to remember, that subject to public order, morality and health, every religious domination or any section thereof shall have the rights. So what are the rights they have? To establish and maintain institution for religious and charitable purpose, to maintain its own affair in a matter of religion, to own and acquire movable and immovable property, to administer such property in accordance with law. No person shall be compelled to pay taxes for the promotion of a particular religion. No religious instruction shall be provided in any institution wholly maintained out of state fund, even though religious instruction may be imparted in educational institutions recognized by or receiving funds from the state. No person attending such institution shall be compelled to receive that religious instruction without the consent of himself or his guardian. So these are the things they enjoy. The next, the most important, you have cultural and educational right. Now, cultural and educational right, these rights are mentioned under Article 29 and 30. So, Article 29 and 30 explains cultural and educational right, where it protects minorities and minorities and educational institution. So, it protects minorities and minorities educational institution. Now, what Article 29 speaks? Protection of minorities? Okay, it gives a section of the people or whole of them the right to preserve their distinction, language, script and culture. Means the people, especially the minorities or the people of every section, they have a right to preserve their different language, script and culture under Article 29. Even in the matter of admission to any educational institution maintained by the state, admission cannot be denied on grounds of religion, color, caste, creed, or sex. The same manner, minorities and educational institution. What do you mean by minorities and educational institution? Now here minorities, Article 30, it is talking, this Article 30 talks about minorities and educational institutions, that Article 30 gives all minorities the right to establish and administer the educational institution of their choice. Means they can have their own, according to their choice, they can have their own educational institution and they can administer as they want. The state is also prohibited from discriminating against educational institutions in the matter of grant. This is again under the cultural and educational right. The last is not last. We have still the right to education, one more right. So, right to constitutional remedies, Article 32, backbone of our article, backbone of our fundamental rights, right to constitutional remedies. Right, fundamental rights are justiciable because of constitutional remedies. Because of right to constitutional remedies, fundamental rights are justiciable. That is, a suit can be filed in High Court or the Supreme Court if fundamental rights are violated. Means you can file a suit, okay, either in the High Court or the Supreme Court if our fundamental rights are violated. Means Article 32, what does Article 32 speaks? It gives the right to constitutional remedies. This right is given to citizens to move Supreme Court for the enforcement of other fundamental rights conferred on them. So, according to Dr. Ambedkar, he described this article as a heart and soul of our constitution. Okay, it is like a heart and soul because it protects our other fundamental rights. That's a reason we say it is justiciable. Okay, so today's class, you studied about right to freedom of religion, where we are free to profess, practice and propagate our religion according to our choice. Cultural and educational right, where protection of minorities and the minorities and the educational institution and right to constitutional remedies, it means we can move to the Supreme Court or the High Court to protect our fundamental rights. So thank you very much. Please learn.